Hello, this is Mike B here from Road Trail Run, and today I'm going to be taking you out for an on-the-run trail review of the Brooks Catamount Agil. Now, we had about 9 inches of snow up at Bogus last night, a lot of rain down in the valley, so kind of drove myself up, find a little bit of a mid-elevation trail here. It's a little bit too muddy, we'll have to turn around, go a little higher up. We should have a good mix of terrain, a little bit of steep climb, some descents, a lot of technical stuff. Should be a good test for the Catamount Agil. Had to turn around over there, a little bit too muddy. Back to the road, next trail up, let's see how this one is. Really liking the feel on technical terrain. A lot of ground feel, close to the ground in these. The upper feels super dialed in. Plate is also good, Sky Vault plate. It's protecting, feel like I'm moving pretty quick on the uphill, similar to the Catamount 3. Get a little bit of uphill impulse, which is nice. Found some better trails there, much better than the first one. No mud over here. The first one I had to run through a few sections of mud on the beginning. Got a little bit too muddy, had to turn around. Brooks handled that pretty good. I wasn't slipping around too much. It wasn't a ton of mud. A little bit in the front, you could see I didn't really get too deep in there. But it has pretty good traction. Back there on some of those rocky sections, the plate felt really nice underfoot. Felt like it was really dispersing a lot of the sharp impacts from the rocks underfoot. It feels low to the ground. It's firm. Definitely not as much cushion as the Catamount 3. Other shoes with a little bit more foam underfoot. You're close to the ground. The upper's dialed in. It kind of has the feel of a Matrix upper. I was thinking about loosening it up, but I think on the run, this is my first run, it just kind of loosened up naturally a little bit and it felt pretty good. So I don't have to really lock down the upper so much, similar to a Matrix upper. You tension it just right with a little bit of give and the upper doesn't really have that stretch back and forth where you feel like you're losing security. Feels really good on the run, solid underfoot. Feels like it's completely attached to the bottom of my foot as I'm going. So I've been running uphill so far. I'm gonna head up this way, wind around a little bit more, a little bit of a rocky descent there. On the way back, I'll be going a little bit faster. Should be better testing on the stability, the security, how the impact feels underfoot. All right, so here we go, next section. Head out along this way. Then we're probably gonna wind along up on that ridge over there. First tracks after yesterday's snow. Dark out here. Whew, hope we don't get caught out. Got a little funky back there. See how the video turns out. Hope you'll appreciate testing conditions as opposed to the actual video quality. We'll see. So I'll come back at you. Want to take them out a few more times. Really dial in my thoughts on the shoe. Probably go a little bit more in depth on the run, on the ride. Really want to focus on some comps on this one. So I've got the Salomon Pulsar, Merrell Long Sky 2 Matrix, the Merrell Skyfire 2 Matrix, also VJ Lightspeed and VJ MAXx2. Those are the closest comps that I have in mind. If you have any others that you can think of, let me know. All right, just doing a quick check. See how that knit collar worked out. Pristine. All right, another test run today. A little bit more snow on the ground this time. Pretty cold too, a lot of crunchy bits. Should be good testing. A lot of time, frozen ground, crunchy ice is really a good stand-in for technical terrain, aside from the slipping factor. But traction's pretty good and agile, so should be good testing. So I kind of bopped around back there on the entrance to this trail. A little bit more crusty back there, a little harder on the ground, getting into some softer snow as I move up now. I just want to talk about the fit of the shoe real quick. It's just awesome. Totally 100% secure. I don't feel any disconnect between the bottom of my foot, the bottom of the shoe, and the ground. Just feels excellent. Also, I want to point out, they didn't narrow it too much under the midfoot. Some light and fast shoes make this really super narrow under the arch area. They went ahead and kept that a bit wider here, and I think that really helps with stability. I didn't feel like I was teetering a little bit. Sometimes with a narrow shoe, you have to be really up on your toes, be really agile. I felt like I could really get a solid plant on here and not worry about that being too tall and having that little bit of wobble. DNA Flash Foam, really energetic. I mean, of course, I'm on snow here, so it's not gonna feel too firm, but I did have some dry sections on my last run, hard pack sections of ice back there. It doesn't feel harsh, but it also doesn't feel soft or even bouncy. It just feels like you have that layer right there and it doesn't want to interfere with your feel of the trail by giving you an extra bounce or really transmitting harshness into your foot. I really like it a lot. I feel like I could use this as an everyday shoe. If you don't want a ton of cushion underfoot, it definitely could be an everyday shoe. So I'm gonna head a little bit higher up that way. Snow should get a little bit softer. I'm kind of in a taper period now, so I don't want to get too crazy in deep snow. I'll probably turn around if it gets a little bit too deep, but I'll take it easy, maybe hike a little bit, get a little work in. Just a gorgeous day out today. I'm just hiking up this side ridge here just for fun. Nobody's been here in the fresh snow, so why not? All right, so that about wraps it up for the review. I'm gonna head back, get you some specs. I'm gonna look into those comps and give some final thoughts on the review. All right, so now the fun part. Just trudged up this trail right here in the snow. Get to run back down, have some fun there. And then the trail I came in on comes down that way through creek back down. There's some other connecting trails over that way, heading all the way on up. But that's for another day. So I'm back in the lab. I got the Agile here. I got a bunch of shoes lined up. I'm gonna really focus on comps here, but first I'm gonna go through some of the things that I loved about this shoe. The ride is just great. DNA Flash, nitrogen infused midsole. It
It's not a ton of stack, feels responsive and fast. Speed vault plate in the bottom. Flex it here. You can see the flex point. It's kind of similar to the Sky Vault plate in the Catamount 3 that I love so much. It has that flex kind of forward of the toes. So when you're climbing, it really feels quick on the uphills and also quick on the run. It gives you a kind of propulsion, a kind of efficiency on the run that just sneaks up on you. It doesn't feel super fast all the time, but you, like some other commenters have posted, and I've noticed myself, you check your watch, you say, whoa, I'm moving pretty quick for this shoe, and I didn't really expect it. The plate has a similar feel in the Agile. Again, that flex is kind of forward of the toe, so climbing, it feels great. If you take a look here, you can see it kind of splits here. I didn't notice any instability from having a flat plate underfoot. It seemed to have good flex. If I'm flexing it laterally, you could see it does flex pretty well. So it's not stiff laterally. I felt it actually was quite agile and didn't really throw my foot. Looking down at the lugs are great. I think they had them at some strange decimal of 4.7. They're definitely higher than in the Catamount 3. And I believe they're the highest out of some of the test pairs that I have here. Definitely great on traction. The upper fits like a glove. It's similar to a Matrix upper, similar to a shoe I have here, the Pulsar. It just wraps well. You don't really have to tension down the laces. It holds the foot perfectly. The heel is just great. Something I talked about in my first impressions review. There's this big, huge bolster around the back of the heel. It goes above your heel bone and you're totally locked in. Feels great. Knit collar, again, something I'll point out on the run, completely wraps the foot. No dirt in there. I ran in snow, muddy conditions, have some mud still on the bottom. Nothing got into my foot, not a pebble, not anything, just perfect. So if you want a fast shoe, a race day shoe, something that feels like it's just attached to the bottom of your foot, wraps around your ankle, nothing's getting in there, just feels like an extension of your body when you're running, this is a great shoe. Great pick. One of my favorite shoes of the year so far. I got on my table here the shoes that I feel are most similar in comparison to the Agile. I've tried them on one by one to kind of refresh my memory. I've run in all these shoes pretty recently, some of them extremely recently, with the exception of the Pulsar. So I'm just gonna go through them one by one. I'm gonna throw a little spec sheet up on the screen. I'm not gonna talk about specs or anything like that. You could pause it, screenshot that, whatever you wanna do. All these shoes are US size 9.5 with the exception of the MAXx2, which is strangely a US 9, strangely for VJ, because VJ typically runs very small. This one runs large. So this one's a 9, and I have my Catamount 3. That's not a similar shoe. I'll talk a little bit of comparison in regards to the Agile version, but I have that one in a size 10. That's my ultra sizing. I like to be a little bit more comfortable if I'm thinking of running these for longer distances. So again, I'm just gonna go through these, kind of talk about which ones I feel are the most similar, maybe look at some of the features here and there. I haven't prepared anything, so this is going to be completely off the cuff. Looking at these two new shoes from Merrell, the Skyfire 2 and the Long Sky 2, I feel like the Brooks is a mashup of these two shoes. The Skyfire 2 is very thin underfoot. The profile of the midsole is similar to the Brooks, but the float pro foam is not as responsive as the Brooks Nitrogen DNA. Upper, very similar in fit. The Matrix gives you a great fit. The Merrell's a little bit squeezier, a little bit narrower. This does have a plate in it, but on the run, this shoe feels very firm underfoot. This is a little bit more forgiving, a little bit more versatile. If you look at this one, very narrow under the midfoot and also through the heel. That's something that I like about the Agile. They maintain this kind of width under the midfoot, which gives it some stability compared to some of these extreme narrow platform type of shoes. And now that's something that carried over from the regular Catamount. they maintain that width through the midfoot, which does give it a lot of stability, a lot of smoothness, and they carry that over to the Agil. So it doesn't quite, it's narrow, of course, but it doesn't quite taper in as far as some of these other shoes. So you do feel that stability under the midfoot, which I really like. So I say it's in between these two shoes because this one has a little bit more stack, feels a little more forgiving underfoot. So the Agil's not as forgiving as this one, but not as hard, full power to the ground as the Skyfire 2. Long Sky 2 doesn't have a plate. This is more flexible. This is, I love this shoe just for everyday running, cruising around. It's kind of a throwback shoe. Really love it. Skyfire 2 does have a plate, so this has some stiffness similar to the Brooks Agil. So you see where I'm going here. Cushioning is kind of in between, but the Brooks has the plate of this. The upper is not quite as narrow as the Skyfire 2. The upper is more similar to the Long Sky 2. One thing to point out, this knit collar, so much better than these new Merrells. Merrell really kind of messed up here. The edging on both of these collars is just floppy. It's worse than a regular collar. They wanted to make it very lightweight and I guess kind of skimp on materials around here, but it lets the breeze in. It's not great. So moving on, we have the new VJ Lightspeed. Look how narrow this gets. This is similar to the Pulsar and also more similar to the Long Sky 2. This is probably even the narrowest one. Compared to the Brooks Agil, you could tell the difference under the midfoot. This shoe is way more stable here. You have a lot more foam underfoot here. This VJ Super Foam Nitrogen Infused, I believe, that's quite similar to the DNA Flash midsole foam here. In terms of all these shoes right here, in terms of the foams, the Brooks is similar to both of these VJ models. The VJ models have more foam underfoot though, so they're gonna be softer, more cushioned. This has a plate in it. You could see this is a very fast shoe with a very soft stack with a very narrow platform. The review on this shoe just dropped today. I like the shoe, I love the shoe, but in technical terrain, it's very narrow, very soft, and very high. You have to be on your toes. You have to be ready to handle this kind of platform the more technical the terrain gets. But on moderate ground, easier terrain, this shoe flies. The softness feels great. The plate gives you a great impulse. Super fast shoe. Whereas in comparison, the Agil feels a little bit harsher on harder ground because you don't have that soft cushion. Still feels fast, but you're going to have more ground feel. I'll just skip over here to the MAXx2. Compared to the Lightspeed, you see a more coverage through the midsole here, more of a wider platform under the midsole. This is a more stable shoe, a more versatile shoe. Stack height, I believe, is 1 or 2 millimeters higher in the MAXx2 here, but same exact foam. So same soft feel, but you get a wider forefoot base, definitely wider under the midfoot and also wider in the rear. So you kind of get some of the properties of Lightspeed, but in a more stable package. This is real, really great shoe. Love this shoe. In terms of handling technical terrain, I'd say the Agil does handle it better. You are closer to the ground. You have more feel. It's similar in platform, slightly narrower, I would say, but this foam gives a little bit more between you and the ground, a little bit more stack, a little bit more softness. Here you feel the ground more, you have more control. I think it's a better, faster technical shoe, but for longer distances, this is a great pick, a more comfortable shoe. The upper has probably a little bit more width here. Crazy to say for a VJ shoe, but it is. You're more locked in for technical terrain in the Agil. Moving on to the original Pulsar. I don't have the soft ground version, so this one has some shallow lugs. Around here in the Boise foothills, it's great, but it's limiting in technical terrain. The lugs on this one are just, it's not even a question here. The Pulsar is narrower through the midfoot, similar to the Skyfire 2, VJ Lightspeed, and it's also taller, similar to the Lightspeed. These two shoes are very similar, but this shoe is extremely light. That's a main difference here. This shoe, by the look standing next to them, looks a full size smaller than all of these shoes, but it's the same 9.5. You have a really snug fit in this Pulsar. I know the SG version, I think they relax the upper a little bit, especially up front. I haven't tried that version, but this one is probably the most dialed upper fit of them all. I have no issues with the forefoot fit in this one because there is decent width across the forefoot. It does narrow a little bit by the toes, but I find I could relax this, and with the Matrix upper, it's not an issue here. Compared to the Agil, this shoe is a little bit higher. You have to pay a little bit more attention in technical terrain just because you're that much higher and it's a little bit narrower. They're very comparable. The Brooks feels more stable. Probably with this plate, it's more propulsive oriented than the Pulsar's plate, which is kind of a flexible protective plate. So this shoe may feel faster, but this shoe, I think the extreme lightness makes up for the disadvantage, possibly with this plate feeling a little bit quicker. Looking at these two knit collars, they're very similar. Brooks almost copied them. It works just as well. It's amazing. One thing I'm slightly concerned about, this stitching in the Agil. They have some open stitching here, and Salomon really thought about this. They covered up that stitching on the inside. I haven't had any issues with the Agil here, but that's something that I definitely noticed, that this stitching is kind of on the back of my heel. I'm not sure if I would take these for an ultra type distance, so I don't think that would come into play. It's a little something that they overlooked that Salomon paid attention to. I hope you enjoyed coming along for a couple of my test runs in the Agil. The scenery in the area, the weather conditions in the area, the comps. Again, let me know down below if you have any specific questions. I'm not gonna pick a favorite amongst all of these shoes, but if you ask me for a particular scenario down in the comments, I'll let you know which shoe I would pick for that scenario. I assure you, the Catamount Agil would surely be in the running for most of those cases. Thank you for watching.